First things first, Lira should be held responsible for the destruction of property that happened last year. A lot of retailers lost their ways, and a lot of indigenous retailers who had actually invested in, some had borrowed money from the banks to try and start up a retail business, and they lost a lot of property. You know, we also have a case of some that lost cell phones, laptops, clothes, dry grocery. And you know, for example, in the case of Choppy's supermarket, Nelson Mandela branch, they went in and some were actually eating pork pies in the shop. And now I'm wondering, is this a demonstration or what is the purpose of this demonstration? So for us as retailers, we are not happy at all about the destruction of property that happened, let alone then to hear that there is also another planned demonstration which is going to be taking place tomorrow. I don't think the agenda for those demonstrations is quite clear for us, and it's actually intended for any other means rather than reversing the economic gains that we have noticed as a country since dollarization. You remember, back then we didn't have food or groceries or products on the shelves. The shelves were empty, and we also we had a lot of other people celebrating our situation where we didn't have products on shelves. And we were quite resolute as the retail sector, as the business community. We opened shops despite the challenges that we faced in 2007-2008, which were largely also due to the economic sanctions that were placed in the country, unjustified sanctions for that matter. So for us then to have this particular situation as the retail sector, I don't think is something that we would want to see happening. In any country, there is no way that whether you're in an organization, you are in an individual business community, you have to respect the laws of the country. There is no way you can work outside the laws of the country and expect to get away with it. This is the reason that why we have even encouraged our membership, because we also had some members that wanted to take the law into their own hands during the demonstrations. But we said, no, don't respond violently. Just let the court take its process and recover whatever that you have lost through the courts. The Zimbabwean constitution is very clear. It respects freedom of association and demonstrations. The new constitution is there within their right. But the same constitution then must protect us, the business community. It must protect, because remember, there are people that have got absolutely nothing to do with this demonstration, that would want to continue going about their duties. They would want to continue going to work. They want to go and shop, do their shopping. They want to take their kids to school. But they should not be impeded. There should not be any impediments. Just like what we saw in the previous demonstrations, where people were forcibly removed from certain shopping centers by these demonstrators to say, you need to join the demonstration. Why do you force someone to join your demonstration where you are doing the system for your own? You've got your own issues that have got nothing to do with me in my family, for example, or myself as a business person, myself as an industrialist. So the same constitution then must also be used to protect those people that are not willing to demonstrate at any particular time. Probably they want to do it at their own time, or they have no business in demonstrating, because they know that the government has done a lot of work towards reviving this economy. Remember, we are talking right now, we are actually preparing to host the breakfast meeting on Bond Notes tomorrow, on the same day that this planned demonstration is purported to be held. We are progressive because we want to look at issues that are affecting the economy with the view of trying to improve on those policies that the government would have enunciated. These Bond Notes have actually been quite successful. It has been instrumental in the actually rise in terms of capacity utilization in Zimbabwe, the same way that Special Instrument 64 has also done in terms of reviving this economy. What we should be seized as Zimbabweans is to ensure that we promote industrialization, we promote production, we actually go out to work for this country, we go out to work for our organizations. Because if we stay at home, if we don't go to work, you should not expect to earn anything, because you are staying at home, industry has stopped. We cannot have a situation where we can afford to lose a day or many hours due to demonstrations, just like we did last time, because the damage that we are talking about, otherwise quantifying it, we can quantify it looking at those, the property that was destroyed. But how about the many hours, the sales revenue that was lost due to the early closures of some shops that were forcibly asked to close? They lost sales because they were not trading. So that is the damage that it does to the economy. So people should also look at it from that angle to say, people can demonstrate the way they want, but that is not the primary focus right now. The primary focus is to rebuild this economy. Remember when this demonstration took place way back, they destroyed the economy. They destroyed, you know, industry. A lot of shops were vandalized. You actually had people carrying carcasses of meat from butchers. You had people carrying refrigerators from, you know, refrigerating stores. So this is the situation that I said, really, as Zimbabweans, why would we want to take us back to such areas? We have done a lot. Some of us, we are not sleeping day and night, working to revive this economy, ensuring that we support the government in all those noble initiatives that they're trying to, intervention, policy interventions that are actually aimed at reviving this economy. And then you have others that are coming through to say, no, that is not something that is important. I don't think that works. Even if you go across the world right now, any country that has done demonstrations, it's not going anywhere. And a lot of the countries have seen that demonstrations do not work. In any case, engagement is the way to go. I'm actually against, totally against the demonstrations for the reason that every time that we have demonstrations in this country, there's destruction of property. Surely, is that then a peaceful demonstration? You have people that were trying. I also noticed a woman at corner Samora Machel and Leopold Takaura, who was actually driving a white, you know, Mercedes Benz, which was stoned. While she was actually, while she had stopped to observe a red traffic light. So those are the issues that we're talking about to say. Really, that's the politics, that such politicking has no space in this economy where we are trying to revive our industry. I don't understand such politicking where you want to destroy business for you to get into power. So when you get into power by whatever time chance, who are you going to be, you know, governing? Because, you know, honestly, you want to destroy us. What have we done? We are not politicians. We are simple, honest business people. And then someone then tries to come through and destroy what we are trying to build. So I'm sure my message to the political parties is that the ends of business. Stay away from business. Do your politics in your political grounds. And leave us as business to do our business. We have got no business involving ourselves in your politics. And you have no business involving yourself in our business. So the message is quite clear. We are totally against violence as business. We are against demonstrations as business.